Hi, welcome to the University of Southampton and British Council MOOC, Understanding Language, Learning and Teaching. Actually, this is the fifth run of this course that we've done over the years, and we're happy to see a lot of new learners join the course again. Actually, this course, we've had 13,000 people have joined the course in total, of which we've got about 2,000 people are already active on the course, completing some steps. And we've got 1,100 social learners, and that's people who have been commenting and interacting with each other. So that's great. We can see a lot of you on step 1.2. We've got this ZMap, the map application, and we can see over 1,700 of you have used the map, and we can see learners from all over the world. So it's great to have a mix of participants on the course, both language teachers and people with an interest in language joining us here today. So we've had a total of 5,000 comments already on the course from all the people commenting, and 10 people have actually already finished the course. So congratulations to those of you that have finished the course, and you can buy a statement of participation if you wish. There's also the chance to get a scholarship. You may be eligible for a scholarship for the University of Southampton and British Council online MA in English language teaching. This scholarship would cover 30% of course fees, and if you're interested in that, look at step 1.18, and there's some further information about that step. So what's been going on this week? Well, we've had a lot of great activity on the course, talking about the different subjects. We had a nice conversation on forum 1.5, I think it was, which was Tim Oakley started a conversation about saying hello in different languages. And other people have joined onto this thread and managed to, we've got lots of people saying hello in their own languages just to kind of greet you to the course. If you want to have a look at that and add your own language to that, you can use the filters on the discussion forums, which is quite a useful tool for you to use the discussions, as there are a lot of comments on these discussion forums. So if you filter, press the filter by like, then you will see in step 1.5, you will be able to see a little bit, if you scroll down a little bit in the discussion forum, you can see Tim Oakley's conversation and people saying hello about that. And that's an important part of the course, is to please use the like button to show that you are, that a conversation or comment thread is interesting or is valuable in some way, and follow people that you think are interesting or have some good ideas. So you might want to follow the mentors or other learners on the course who you have share experiences with or whatever. But if you use those functions to follow and like and then filter by most liked conversations, you will find the conversations which are most active and people are most interested in. So that's really useful for you. We also had a comment from Carlos Jimenez Clement, who was talking about whether we are naturally built to speak one language or more than one language, and whether which comes most naturally to people. And one of the other mentors on the course, Josh Underwood, was able to post an interesting link to a news story about how learning languages can be beneficial to your health in some way. So that's really interesting, and we'll post the links at the bottom of this video. We also had discussions of implied meaning, which were quite good fun. That's step 1.8. And there were some nice examples of implied meaning in English language. For example, when people say, what time do you call this? They're not actually asking what time it is. They're trying to say to somebody, you're late, and I'm not happy that you're late. So this is a classic example of implied meaning. And another good post which we can share with you was by Miller Marion, who discussed a classroom activity for practicing implied meaning, which is called a split exchange, where different people have different information and they have to talk to each other to try and find match a pair of these things. But have a look at this conversation if you're interested in a nice classroom activity for exploring implied meaning. There was another discussion from Mike Troop, where people were discussing whether fluency or accuracy is more important in language learning, and this is a debate which I suppose has been going on for a long time, and you can see some interesting views in that one. And we will post a link at the end of this underneath this video to a British Council page which explains the idea of communicative competence as a target for language learning. And explains what this important concept of communicative competence is, what it's made up of, and how people can try and achieve it. And you can follow some further information if you're interested in that one. It will come up again later in week two, I expect. Finally, we've got an interesting conversation from Karen Rawlinson on language and power, and how power relations can operate in language teaching and in the learning of languages more generally. And there are a lot of examples through history how language and power are closely linked. We'll also, I posted in that comment thread, and we'll post to this video, a link from the English Language Teaching Journal, the ELT Journal, which is about criticality in language teaching. And that addresses some of these subjects about power and equality and things like that in language teaching. And we'll post that for you. So I hope you keep using the comments threads and discussing things with each other. It's a great opportunity, this course, to talk to other learners and language teachers all around the world. As you can see from the ZMap, there are people from all over the world on this course. And I hope you'll be able to continue with us in week two. So good luck with the rest of week one, and hopefully I'll see you in week two. Bye-bye.